B-Monster Laboratory here. You may have purchased a wireless weather station, and you're wondering how to keep your wireless weather station outdoor sensor dry. Today I'll be testing the Crosse Technology Sensor Protection Shield to see if it does its job. Let's get started. This sensor shield has a weatherproof casing, and I really like the tiered plate design that gives it plenty of air ventilation. I'm going to go with a really low-tech test here. Everybody knows that when you get cardstock wet, it gets dark. You can see the water real easy. Now I have a clean, dry piece, and I'm going to place it inside the sensor shield, the same place that the sensor would be sitting. Alright, well here it is. This is about as artsy as I get. Now I'm going to place the cover on top. I'm going to lock it into place. I'm going to take it outside and put a little bit of water on it and see if that paper turns dark. Well, I think all was going well there until the very end when I sprayed it too hard from the side. Yeah, I'm going to have to redo this one. This time I'll just pour a bottle of water on it. But where this is located, it will never see anywhere near this amount of rain. It'll see very little rain, but I really want to stress test this thing, I guess you could say.
It'll never rain like that, but...
Alright, time to open it up and see how much of it got wet. It's not bad, just a little part on the bottom. And that may have got wet through capillary action. It just soaked up from the bottom there. So I'm not worried about that at all. So I'm pretty happy with the performance of this shield. So I'll just go ahead and connect the sensor to the stand inside and set it outside and not worry about it. After buying the wireless weather station, I went through all the scenarios of where I could put the outdoor sensor, including screwing it into the side of the house, but who wants to put a hole in their house? I also thought about building my own ventilated box to put my outdoor sensor in. In the end, you're going to spend more time and just as much money as you would if you went online and just bought the sensor protection shield. Thank you all very much for watching the video. Let me know what you thought of my low-tech test, and if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe.